Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech from CanhamTrailers.com. And I just wanted to give you a little update on the 48 mainline Silver Lodger. And as you can see, it's back. Finally. After almost 8 weeks of being in the paint shop for a 2-day clear coat spray job. We had nothing but problems with this thing ever since I started putting the metal on, but it's finally over with and I can get back to finishing it up now. So now, as you can see, I'm getting all the window trim put back in it. I took that out for the spray job because it didn't need clear coat. This stuff here, the tape peels off of it, and it'll be all shiny chrome. That'll look really nice. This is the sill, and I'm getting this stuff all installed all the way around so we can put the glass in it. So can't wait to get it out of here because it's just basically been here too long, and I want it to go away. It's been a fun build. It's been a little taxing on my mental faculties as far as the metal is concerned, because I've never really done one like this where we had shiny aluminum. And I'll tell you, you got to be very careful when you're working on it once you get this aluminum on, because there's no way to fix a dent or a scratch or anything. You just have to be very careful. So that's been a little tough. At any rate, here it is, and I'll give you just a quick little walk around, show you what's going on with it, what it looks like, and then I'm going to get back to work. One of the things I'm really happy about is what you're looking at right now. I had these emblems made. There's one on each side, because of course you can't get them anymore. I had a very old photograph of a Silver Lodger with the wings on it, with the emblems on it, and I gave that to a buddy of mine who's an artist and a printer, and he's also the one that's making stickers for me now. At any rate, he made these emblems for me, and they are just beautiful. And they've been covered with clear coat, UV resistant clear coat, and they were made out of really nice vinyl. So they'll last a very long time in the sun. If you need emblems made for your trailer and you have a photograph or a drawing, you want to use this guy. I'll put his link in the bottom underneath the video here in the more info box. So link below. He's the same one that made these vinyl stickers for me. And if you like the looks of this sticker, they're about 7 inches wide. If you would like one or two of these, there'll be a link below for those too. You can get those from me. The owner, Kelly, is a good old friend of mine from AirTrash. As some of you know, AirTrash is my old skydiving club. It's the largest active skydiving club in the world. And I've been a member for going on 40 years now. Ever since I first started skydiving in 1981. Yep, that's me making one of my first jumps out of a DC-3 in Lake Elsinore, California. So if you want one of these stickers for yourself or for your trailer or your tow vehicle, there'll be a link below where you can get these. So for a quick walk around and what's left to do, like I say, I've got 3 windows on this side and 2 on the other side that need this trim installed, and then I can get the glass in. Then there's one of these windows in back, and as you can see, there's 2 in the front. They need H gasket and the glass installed, and I'm having my glass guy do that. He should be here tomorrow so he can take a look at everything and get the materials. I still need to install the electrical inlet for this trailer. And then of course I need the tail lights and the license plate light. I need to rehang the door. I also need to go ahead and put the stack in for this heater. It goes right up through that hole. and I need to polish the floor. And usually the very last thing I do on any trailer is install the top vent. It's out there and ready to go. I'm really happy with the way the woodwork came out on the inside of this trailer. It just pops. It's so nice. So we're nearing the end of this project and I can't wait to deliver it to Anita. I can't wait to see the look on her face when she sees this trailer for the first time since she gave it to me a few years back. And you'll be right there along with me to catch that look on her face also. So wish me luck and we'll see you next time. In the meantime, this is Larry from CanhamTrailers.com. Mobile tech as you know me, reminding you that I make mistakes so you don't have to. We'll see you next time, folks. Have a good one and stay safe.